Is VR bad for your eyes? That's probably the most common question that I've gotten since my last video about VR. So I wanted to go over four areas of where VR potentially could be bad for your eyes, but there could be potential benefits to the eyes. Let's focus in. Hey, howdy everybody, this is Dr. Neil Gaiman, Dr. Eye Guy, and I want to go over the short-term potential effects as well as the long-term potential effects that VR systems might have on your eyes. So let's jump right into the first topic. This area relates to the digital eye strain that you could potentially get from staring at the screens in the VR device. And a lot of the symptoms are similar, in fact, the same as computer vision syndrome, what people get when they're looking at computer screens or their phone screens for long periods of time. They can get tired and also feel headaches. The big one is actually your eyes will dry out. And that's from actually staring at the screen because we tend to blink way, way, way less when we're staring at a screen. Same thing with VR. And that could potentially be harmful for the surface of your eyes. It can cause redness, irritation, burning, stinging, dry patches on the surface of your eye that can cause blurry vision. And so you definitely want to obey the 20-20-20 rule that I talk about in my other video. One potential long-term effect from frequent digital eye strain and not blinking from using a lot of VR is damage to the oil glands inside of your eyelids. We're noticing that people that use computer screens and their phones for long periods of time, we're finding that the oil glands of their eyelids are actually atrophying. They're shrinking down because that blinking isn't there, that mechanical blink to squeeze the oil glands and get this fresh, nice, healthy layer of oil onto the surface of your eyes isn't there. And this could potentially be very, very harmful in the future because once those oil glands are gone, they're gone. They're pretty much impossible to get back. And so you might be dealing with a chronic bad dry eye issue in the future. So be sure that you obey that 20-20-20 rule for that reason. That's probably the biggest reason is you don't want your oil glands to disappear and cause a future potential problem with dry eye disease. The second area has actually been talked about a lot on certain VR forums and other videos, and something called divergence accommodation conflict. So let me go over the individual terms so you know what they mean. Accommodation is the name for your eyes focusing system. When you actually look at your phone screen or something up close, you will accommodate or focus. Vergence, convergence, or divergence is your eyes posture or your eyes movement to be able to look at something and make it one single image. You will converge to look at your phone screen, something up close, and then you'll diverge when you look at something far away, trying to make that image one single image. What's really interesting about these two systems is that they can be linked and actually work together. So when you look at your phone, you'll accommodate your eyes, and also at the same time, your eyes will converge to make that a single image, a single clear image. And at the same time, they'll diverge to look at something far away, and your accommodation will relax. So they kind of work in harmony together. The divergence accommodation conflict happens in VR devices because VR devices usually set their focal point for distance or far away. And so your accommodation will want to relax to make the image clear, but at the same time, your visual system knows that there's something close to your eyes, and so they'll want to converge to make the image single, a single clear image. So they have this constant conflict where they're used to working in harmony together, and all of a sudden you put on a device that kind of separates the two systems a little bit. I think this is actually the area where you'll hear a lot of doctors warning against VR systems because they could potentially be harmful to the eyes because they could be mistraining the systems of the eyes and working against that harmony that they're used to. But the nice thing about the eyes is that they are elastic, so they can snap back. So as long as you're taking breaks every 20, 30 minutes, then your eyes can snap back into that harmonious system that they're used to. Also in the future, they are working on better lenses for VR devices that can be multi or varied focal distances and being able to move the lenses a little bit so you can actually be able to use that harmony of the accommodation and the vergence together. So I don't see this potentially being a bigger problem in the future. I think they are working on solving this issue currently. The third area relates to the actual blue light that's coming from the device. And I did a whole video about blue light coming from the Oculus Quest 2 and if it was bad for your eyes. You can check out that video right there, also in the description below. But that video also pertains to other VR devices as well. The main gist is that the blue light could potentially be contributing to digital eye strain. The studies are mixed on that. Some say no, some say yes. The one thing that the blue light can do is that it can affect your sleep cycle. So if you are playing the device closer to bedtime, then you could potentially be awake all night because that blue light affected your sleep cycle. So try and use the blue light filter as much as you can. Try and avoid playing VR towards bedtime, which is really difficult to do. But if you do those things, then you're doing what you can do to try and keep your eyes safe from the blue light. The fourth area is a question that I get all of the time, and that's if VR is causing our vision to get worse, meaning is it causing us to get more astigmatism? Is it causing us to become nearsighted or farsighted? And that's also studied a lot with computer use and phone use and tablet use, because more and more people on this planet are becoming nearsighted, meaning their distance vision is becoming blurry. And so the worry and a lot of studies are trying to find out if it's because of our phone use and our tablet use. Pretty much our world is really close to us, so are we adapting to this close-up world? Now, here's where one benefit comes out with the VR device, is a lot of times VR is set for distance, meaning that we're relaxing our accommodation and focusing far away. A lot of times our accommodation can be relaxed when we're looking in the VR device. So that's one benefit that the VR has over looking at your phone screens or your tablets or even the computer screens, is that you get to relax and look far away. You don't even have to use your accommodation to try and focus up close. But bottom line, if you are using a VR device and you obey the 20-20-20 rule, you take breaks, you blink, you move your eyes around, maybe you use eye drops, you're using the blue light filter, you're being smart about your eyes, you're taking care of your eyes. If you feel a headache, if you feel an eye strain, take a break. Let your eyes bounce back to what they usually do. Bounce back into that harmonious level, and I think your eyes will last a long time, and you can avoid a lot of those potential long-term side effects of using a VR device. A couple more benefits that I want to add at the end of the video is a lot of VR devices or something similar are being used for people that have already damaged vision, meaning they have very, very low vision, maybe due to an eye disease or trauma or something like that. They can actually use a VR device to magnify images, maybe watch TV to make them look really, really big, and actually is bringing back some of their functional vision. And so that's one benefit that I'm actually really excited about, the potential, the future potential of helping these people that have low vision. Another benefit that actually use VR devices in kids that have a lazy eye or one eye that is not seeing as well as the other eye. They'll have them play a VR game in a VR device, and they're able to change the lenses or the focal points of the lenses, maybe make one eye blurry, so they can actually train the brain to use that lazy eye and maybe strengthen that eye. And so that's also another exciting part of VR and where it can actually be beneficial and actually help people with eye problems. If you have any questions about VR and eyes, make sure that you leave it down in the comments. I actually try my best to try and answer all the questions that I get on these videos. Make sure that you check out my other videos as well. I'll leave those in the description about astigmatism, my other VR and eye videos, the blue light video, so that you can have that to reference to. Now, I plan on doing a part two to this video, and that's if VR is bad for kids' eyes. So make sure that you're subscribed for that when I release that video. I'm Dr. Neil Gaiman, Dr. Eye Guy, focusing on you and your eyes. Check out my other videos right there, and I'll see you in the next video.